Praise be the name of Jesus. Dear friends, today we reflect on the greatest commandment of love. On a busy morning, an elderly gentleman came to a doctor to have his routine checkup. That day, he was in a hurry. He said that he had another appointment within an hour. So the doctor decided to attend him immediately. Having examined him, the doctor found that he was healthy, and so he gave him his regular medicines. The old man was looking at his watch from time to time. So the doctor asked him, "You said you have another appointment. Are you going to meet another doctor?" "No," he said. "I have to go to the nursing home to have breakfast with my wife." The doctor was very much taken up with his concern for his wife. And so he inquired more about his wife. He asked him about her health. He said that his wife was there in the nursing home for quite some time and that she was suffering from Alzheimer's disease. Since he was in a hurry, the doctor asked him if his wife would be upset if he was a bit late. The man replied with tears in his eyes, "She has not recognized me for 5 years. The doctor was surprised and he asked him, "Why do you still go every morning to have breakfast with her, even though she doesn't know who you are?" The man smiled and said, "She doesn't know me, but I still know who she is." True love is neither physical nor romantic. It is an acceptance of the other person as he or she is. In the Gospel according to St. Matthew chapter 22, verse 37, when Jesus was asked about the most important commandment, he said, "You must love the Lord your God with all your heart, all your soul, all your mind, and all your strength." Then he added, "The second is equally important. Love your neighbor as yourself. No other commandment is greater than this. To love God is to accept Him as your Lord. To love God with your heart means to love God with all your emotions. Praising God with happiness, smile, and gratitude is easy when things are going on well. But how about when things are not going on that well? Loving the Lord with all your heart means at all times, even when God seems quiet. Loving God is a day-to-day commitment. If we love the Lord as we should, that is with all our heart, with all our might, and with all our strength, we will not sin against Him. Our whole being is acting in love. He will be our top priority, and we will be doing all things well. But there is a problem with our relationship with God. We will not be living in communion with Christ. So loving the Lord with all our heart is necessary to experience a full and abundant life. As in Psalm 16 we read, "In His presence is fullness of joy, and in His right hand there are pleasures forever." By loving Him with all our heart, I place myself in this position of joy. To love others as yourself would mean to treat others as you would like them to be treated. In Matthew chapter 7, verse 12, we read, "So in everything, do to others what you would have them do to you. For this sums up the law and the prophets." This love for others flows from our relationship with God. When we are out of line with God, it is far easier to harm others. All the evils of this world are wrought about by lack of love. That is why in Exodus chapter 22, verse 20, thus says the Lord, "If ever you wrong them and they cry out to me, I will surely hear their cry." If we love our neighbors as we should, then we would not offend them and offend God. If we truly love our neighbor, we are less likely to sin against them. Because you cannot hurt or hate one that you love. So if you're hurting or hating, you are no more loving. In short, what Jesus is telling us is that if we love the Lord supremely with everything we have and we are, we will love those around us as strongly as we love ourselves. We are able to love others with their limitations because Jesus loved us with our limitations. St. Paul tells us in his letter to the Thessalonians in chapter 1, verse 5 and 6, "You became imitators of the Lord so that you became model for all believers." Therefore, dear friends, let us continue to love the Lord our God with all our hearts, all our soul, and all our mind, and loving our neighbors as ourselves. And we will start seeing the world around us changing for the better, with less evils brought about by lack of love. With the psalmist, let us proclaim, I love you, Lord, O Lord, my strength, my rock, my fortress, my deliverer. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.